Assalamu alaikum and Ramadan Mubarak to you all. Welcome to the Health Show, a Ramadan special with me, Alistair Greener. Ramadan is a time for spiritual reflection, self-improvement, devotion and worship. This is a time when Muslims are expected to put more effort into following the teachings of Islam and to maintain obligatory fasting during the whole month. During this blessed month, we'll be bringing you this special program covering the health aspects of fasting and praying. The topics we'll be looking at will include the significance of Ramadan for Muslims, the place of Ramadan in the whole Islamic world, how Ramadan benefits society, and the odd nights and revelation of the Quran, focusing in particular at the health benefits physically and emotionally from an alternative viewpoint. Discussing these topics, it's a pleasure to welcome a renowned Muslim scholar, Yasmin Ahmad. She'll guide us through the series. Originally from Pakistan, Yasmin has a degree in Islamic studies and has educated herself privately, learning the translation of the Quran. To further her knowledge, she did a Quran Alima degree from the Islamic Institute in London and then a diploma of Sahih Bukhari. Now she devotes her time as a volunteer teaching the Quran and Sunnah in and around London. Yasmin, thank you so much indeed for joining us for the series.
Thank you for having me.
It's going to be a great series, and I know for many people this is going to be of real value for them as they go through the whole holy month of Ramadan. But to start this special series, and before we go into the detail of what you should be eating and how best to keep your fast, let's go back a few steps and look at the actual significance of Ramadan for Muslims. So tell us a little bit about the significance of fasting during Ramadan. Why is that such an important part?
Ramadan is a sacred month for the Muslims. For most, it is the anniversary of Quran. Quran revealed in this month. And one Quran Surah also, it's mentioned in Allah's book. We can see this is a Surah of Quran. One ayah it comes before in the Surah Baqarah, Shahru Ramadan allazi unzila fihi al-Quran. This is a month which month Allah revealed the Quran. And one another Surah, this is Surah Qadr. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr, wama adraka ma laylatul qadr, laylatul qadri khayrun min alfi shahr. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. Indeed, we sent it down during the night of decree. And what can make you know what is the night of decree? The night of decree is better than 1,000 months. The angel and the spirit Jibreel descend therein by permission of their Lord for every matter. Peace it is until the emerge of dawn. So this is Allah's book also mentioned in this. So this is the month for us. It is keep fasting, and it is only 1 month is Ramadan. This is where the Muslim followed the practicing 4 pillars of Islam. Like we can be, it is like Tawheed, like Salah, like fast, charity. 4 pillars we can, this is practiced in this month.
And of course, that's always been there. So I'm quite interested to see how the whole fasting practices evolved historically to the present day. You know, we live in a very, very different world to when the Quran was written. So tell us a little bit about that and how it's evolved and how it works in today's very busy life.
Yeah. Because this is fasting, it is familiar for everybody, for all major religion. This is, that is 4 books Allah mentioned in the Quran by names. Torah, it is sent upon Hazrat Musa, Moses alayhi salam. And Injil, it's sent upon Hazrat Isa, Jesus alayhi salam. And Quran, it is for the Hazrat Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for them. And Zubur, this is for the Prophet David, Hazrat Dawud alayhi salam. All major religion or all major books, they having the ritual of fasting. But it was different way. Some people, they was doing on 24 hours. They was doing, it is alternative days. Some was doing for the 40 days. In Christianity also, they doing for 40 days. Prophet Moses also, he does fasting for 40 days. But in Quran, Allah says, one give you 1 month. So, Shahru Ramadan al-Lazi unzila fihi al-Quran. So, 1 month, this is, there is a Quran sent down. So, this is for you, you have to do in this is. So, we have to do this is practice for the fasting. And for us, it is because it is practice to do everything. This is not anything new. We just need to generate again, because sometimes we forget things. It is like a mentally and spiritually you be practiced and in the discipline.
Now, you talk about fasting being different, you know, the way that it evolved and became the whole month of Ramadan that people were fasting. Yeah. How else is the fasting during Ramadan different to other types of fasting?
Because this is the full month, it is we have to do this one. It is how Allah guide us, how our Prophet told us which one is. Because it is a time suggestion. It start from the dawn to dusk. It is we have to do pre-dawn meal, because this is different. It is our Prophet says you have to. This is a sehri. We call it suhoor. Pre-dawn meal. It is a called suhoor. So Prophet says it is a barakah in it. You do this one that time, and then it is for yourself. It is comes to the for the salah, for the prayer, for the night prayer, and also your charity, and also you give food to the others. Otherwise, that is other fasting. It was not in the especially in 1 month, are also not specific. Because some people, they was not doing the complete how Prophet teach us, because we are not allowed to do any things. Many things we are stopped to do. Many things we need to that is give up those things, because our Prophet, peace be upon him, said, whoever does not give up their futile talk, our sins, our bad habits, Allah have no need for him to do and to give up his food and his drink. So that's why it is basically we need to learn something, and learn something, it is a piety, taqwa, this is a fear of God, and be in the line on the guidance and be on the right track.
And it's interesting that, you know, it is more than just the physical element, yes, of fasting. There's the emotional, there's the spiritual,
you
and so
right
on. Let's talk a little bit about the do's and don'ts. So, for example, how you prepare for the fast, and then how you break the fast, and what exactly you can do during the fasting period. Maybe just clarify that for us.
Yes. So this is because first of all, we have to do, we wake up, because this is a barakah in that the Prophet suggests for us, you have to wake up and eat something. That doesn't mean it is we have to need very big meal in the early morning, a very big meal in the afternoon, and fill up your stomach to the bottom to on top. Not like that. This is for your freshness. And when you wake up, and also energy level also, you can see sometimes how much you and which food you are selecting for yourself. This is giving you energy or things. So this way you can have some early morning food and meal, and then pray as well. And then it is then, because that time you feel very fresh, because when you have enough sleep and you wake up, you have little bit refreshment, and then you do salah, and spiritually you are related with your God, and then you can feel satisfaction in your heart, and then this way it is you can start your day. But days, it is Ramadan or fasting day, it is not like that we are spending our times to watch movies and to listen the music and to go for the shopping and kill your time into other activities. So this is not like that. This is completely for yourself and for the society. This is benefit not just for ourselves. This could be benefit for the society as well. for our benefit. It is because our heart should be with the Allah's teaching, our Prophet's teaching, or it is the time for ourselves. We should be on the track, or on the learn something and listen something and be practiced in something. So that's why we need to do it is and daytime spent with the Allah's zikr, because this is a month of Quran.
Yeah, and I like the way that you say that effectively it's more holistic. It's not just the simple process of fasting. There's so much more than that with the prayers and so on. One of the things that we always hear a lot about when it's Ramadan is preparing and breaking the fast is to have dates. Dates are seen as something particularly significant. Tell us more about that.
Yeah. This is a sunnah. And also scientifically also you can see this is a, it is a lot of quantity, iron quantity in it. And also it is instant energy. It can supply to you, to the body. So this way, and also sugar level also sometimes it is down. And if you eat this is, so then this is also not necessary. We have to eat a lot of dates. It could be one as well. It could be a little bit part as well.
And actually, there's a lot of wisdom to say not too many dates, isn't there?
True. And also food also. That is, even it is a morning meal, even it is evening meal. We don't need to spend a lot of time on the cooking and eating or those things. Not like that. And also, it is our Prophet, peace be upon him, said, it is a one hadith from the Muslim and Bukhari. Prophet, peace be upon him, said, this is make your stomach in three parts. One part for the food, one part for the drink, and one should be empty for the air. So this way you should be feel more healthy or more active, because this is not teaching our Prophet you have to fill your stomach in bottom to top. So this is not only spend our time for the food.
Now, but I was going to say, this is a challenge sometimes, isn't it? When you break the fast, you almost become obsessed of cramming in, you know, your whole day's worth of food in a short period of time. What are your top tips for people to be able to sustain their energy through what could be a long day? Not quite so bad at this time of year, this year, but in previous years when it's been at the height of the summer. But still, it's a long time to maintain energy if people are working, going about their normal activities during the day. Yes. So what advice do you have in terms of the type of food that's really good? And then how do you do that between breaking the fast and then preparing for your next day's fast?
That's true. Because this is sometimes it is for us, it is more knowledgeable person. It was Allah's Prophet. So he teaches many things. So that's why those things, it is really beneficial. First of all, it is a sunnah to use the dates. Then to use the fruits like figs, like dates, figs, grapes, those things. This is really beneficial for the stomach. And also one meal also prepared on those days, this is also sometimes we forget those things. It is like we are early morning when we wake up, we have cereals like that. It was our porridge. We can say this is porridge because Allah's Prophet, he liked this one and he mentioned this one. It is in the hadith as well. Milk and that is oatmeal cooked together. And then pour some honey or some dates. Use this one.
Oats are particularly good, aren't they? Because they have quite a slow release of energy over a long period of time,
don't
they?
That's true. And honey also. And they can use some dry nuts as well. So this is really, it is not very heavy for stomach, but it is really, they give you energy, energetic as well. And in the evening also, because this is, and sometimes if you have yogurt, this is also really nice, because sometimes you have yogurt, it is, you cannot feel the thirst.
Well, actually, you talk about thirst. What about the liquid intake? How much liquid, what type of liquid is good? Should it be just plain water, maybe juices? What do you recommend?
Yeah, because this is, water is basically, it is the main element. And also, if they use the fresh fruits, they also contain with the natural juices or water. So this is also very good. And when we open the fast, because it is not that way, we cannot say it is very long. Just control your desires and wishes. This is a more mainly practiced, because if we allow things and we can eat, our Creator said no, we are stopping or not. So mainly it is that. So this is, He is not putting us and putting any pressure on us, and his teaching or His methods, they are also not giving us any sickness.
What about people who maybe have dietary requirements, people who maybe have conditions that might dictate what they can and can't eat? What's your suggestion with that?
Yeah. This is in the Allah's book, it is mentioned very clearly. If the sick, they don't need to do the fast. If they cannot do, if they are sick, they don't need to do it. If they have money, they can give the money to the poor, or they can give the food to the others. Because if somebody give the food to the person who is fasting, if we are giving food to him and he open fast with our food, Allah give us same reward, whatever he is gaining. This is for us as well. And this is because like that, it is in mentioned in the Quran. So I can see this one. Shahru Ramadan al-Lazi. This is a Surah Baqarah, second chapter, and ayah number 185. Shahru Ramadan al-Lazi unzila fihi al-Quran hudal lin-nasi wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan faman shahida minkum ash-shahra falyasum wa man kana maridan aw ala safarin fa iddatun min ayyamin ukhar yuridu Allahu bikum al-yusra wa la yuridu bikum al-usra wa litukmilu al-iddata wa litukabbiru Allaha ala ma hadakum wa la'allakum tashkurun. I'm just reading the meaning of this. The month of Ramadan, in which was revealed the Quran, a guidance for the people and clear proof of guidance and criteria. So whoever cites the new moon, the month, let him fast it. And whoever is ill or on a journey, then an equal number of other days Allah intends for you ease and does not intend for you hardship. And period, and to glorify Allah for that which He has guided you, and perhaps you will be grateful. So this is the clear sign from the Allah. If somebody he cannot do, it is not obligatory for him. It is his exemption for them.
And we would always say here on the health show that if you have any concerns about your health, see your doctor, and your doctor will advise whether he or she feels it's safe and appropriate for you to fast. And if the doctor is saying no, then that's a very clear indication that's what the advice you should be following.
That's true.
And likewise, in terms of types of food, you were saying before about keeping it nice and simple, having water, some juices, some nuts and things. Are there any foods that you would recommend avoiding during Ramadan?
Yes, this is because this is junk food, fried food, more spicy food. This is also, it is not good for health anyway, and other reason as well. But for those days especially, because you want to do more special things, you want to do more things. It is like your sleeping pattern also different, your day pattern also different. You spending a lot of time with the Quran, with the zikr, with the things, because this is not spending our fast on the bed. We are not spending.
And interesting enough that by doing this healthier lifestyle during Ramadan, not just physically, emotionally and spiritually, but actually looking at what you're eating, maybe it's a great opportunity to reconnect not just with your faith, but in terms of better health as well.
Yes, true. Because nowadays many scientists also, many doctors, they're telling you, you can do the diet, just fruit diet, just soup diet, just drink diet. So this is also they're suggesting. So Allah give us 1 month so we can do completely many diets. We can keep them.
It's remarkable the wisdom of the Quran sometimes, isn't it? That even in today's world, the lessons that are in there can be so well applied for today to effectively get us back to the basics of what we should be doing in terms of eating, our faith, and so on. What other advice would you give people during this very special holy month when it comes to fasting? What else would you suggest?
This is basically because it's very few days. It could be 29, it could be 30. And 11 months we was enjoying our times and we was eating and we was just doing whatever we want. But this month it is specially whatever we did wrong, we can seek forgiveness. We can gain some piety. We can gain some relation with our Creator, because many things knowingly or unknowingly we are doing wrong. And also we are making angry to our created. So that's why this month basically we need to gain something to do, because whatever qualities, best qualities, because everybody having best qualities as well. This is not we are only having that is different things, but this is what we having good. We need to spread, we need to spend, we need to utilize it.
And I know that not only are you helping guide us through Ramadan, of course you yourself will be enjoying Ramadan and everything that comes along with it, and a great opportunity for you to reflect and look at your own personal way that you enjoy the fast and enjoy the whole month.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much indeed for joining us. It's been great, and I'm looking forward to our other episodes where we'll find out even more about Ramadan. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
But unfortunately, that is all we have time for today. But we must stress, as we mentioned earlier on, that should you suffer from any medical problems, it's always highly recommended that you contact your doctor or GP, as this program gives you an alternative viewpoint to the health concern being discussed. I would like to thank our guest again, Yasmin Ahmad, for coming on to the show and sharing her opinions and thoughts on today's topic. If you'd like to find out more about the show or the significance of Ramadan or a link to the program, then please do email us at healthshow@islamchannel.tv. That's healthshow@islamchannel.tv. Or, as always, visit us on our website, islamchannel.tv. Join Yasmin and I again next week, where we'll be discussing the place of Ramadan in the Islamic world. Thank you for watching. Goodbye for now. Assalamu alaikum.